right, so we're here with Jeff. How do you pronounce your last name?
Shamanic.
Shamanic. And this business is called Rochester Play.
Correct.
And it's in the location where the old Rochester Library was, public library. So tell us a little bit about the facility and, you know, when you opened, what your philosophy is here.
Certainly. Obviously, with the kids of our own, we've been to a number of different children's centers and experienced a lot of different child care environments. So we were looking for to offer something to the community that really promoted an active, healthy lifestyle. So the services, the designs, the equipment, the food that we serve are all kind of upbeat in regards to looking at how healthy, you know, and how to promote an active lifestyle. So our foods are very whole, nutritious. We have organic options, gluten-free options. The play center is very much an active play center. So
you hear the noise in the background here.
Exactly. That's the nice part about it. And then our other services are designed to you know, help children and parents, you know, learn the benefits of, you know, again, that active, healthy lifestyle.
And one of the services, well, there's a couple things you can do. You can just come in here and play for on an hourly basis. And for what ages is that?
Sure. We designed this for kids young and old. There are a number of centers that target primarily a younger crowd, toddlers and preschools. But we know that the benefit of siblings and everything else, it makes it useful to have the place designed for children of, you know, school age years as well. So we've got a dedicated toddler area for kids under four, and then our play structure, our big play structure, really can handle kids that age and up to, you know, pretty much 12 years of age or, you know, very young teen.
I was here yesterday with my granddaughter, and I noticed you had the Lions game on, so you're also, you know, men can come in here and hang out with their kids.
Certainly, you know, obviously that's important for parents, both mom and dad, you know, to feel comfortable here. So we designed that in mind. Obviously, you know, I'm sure the Lions game was on Sunday.
Good game yesterday.
Which they won yesterday. The comfortable seating that we have, again, we try to make that a little bit above average and you know, them feeling comfortable so that they can socialize or even engage with their kids in the play. So the structures are all designed for the parents to join the kids if they choose. Otherwise, they can jump on the Wi-Fi service or watch TV.
So parents can come here if they happen to work from home or they have a day where they can spend with the kids, maybe not have to go into the office that day, they can hang out here and do their work on the Wi-Fi service.
Absolutely. And we get a lot of parent groups coming here as well. PTA groups come here and meet where their children play. They meet at the tables. And
do you have people to supervise the kids or at least watch over them while they're playing?
The way we designed the area, indoor play structures, no, that's a parent-supervised area. When we restructure the child care, that's when we'll watch the kids while the parents can actually leave the building at that point in time with our licensed child care.
And so you make people sign in, I noticed.
Yes.
You get all their information.
Yes.
Are you kind of keeping an eye on the door and so that kids aren't...
Absolutely. You know, the way we're structured there, you know, within position of that, just simple things from parents opening the door versus us opening the door or the kids being able to open the door. You want the parents to control their children's time here, you know, and monitor them. So there's a lot of safety features we've done with the play structure as well. Our outside netting is a special design netting for no climb ability.
So you don't have kids falling off the structure.
That's right. Very important, that aspect. We've done recycling throughout the facility. From a business perspective, that's somewhat challenging. It's a little bit different than what you have residential where they come and pick it up. And we feel it's important to be eco-friendly in what we do as well. So we've introduced recycling both for the parents and the children to learn the value of that. Our cleaners are eco-friendly. Our sanitizers are alcohol-free. So again, that healthy and eco-friendly approach is important to us as well.
And you also do kids' birthday parties here?
Parties. We have a
and those are just on the weekends?
Oh no, they can be happening every time. We give a discount for parties during the week. We have packages designed for letting us take care of it all for the parents, or we'll work with the parents and let them kind of pick and choose, you know, the type of party that they want and how much involved they want to be in the setup and preparation.
Okay. Anything else that you're doing here that you want to make our readers aware of?
Well, we're going to be introducing a lot of program-based services. classes, specific activities, you know, for parents to join with their kids or to be part of the licensed child care program. And every design that we're doing with that is, say it's an art and craft class or a dance class or bringing in authors to read books. Everything will be combined with a play session. So it'll be art and play, crafting and play, you know, dancing and play. So following the structured time of those activities, the kids will have a chance to play as well. So it gives them a chance to, again, have more active play, you know, in their daily
activities. And this isn't really meant as a daycare center. This is more like the maximum you allow a child to stay as far as daycare would be a 4-hour stint?
That's correct. At this point in time, we were considering, you know, what we could do there going forward. But at this point, our child care was a drop-in, you know, call ahead, you know, reserve your spot type of approach.
So mom could come down with some girlfriends, go to lunch, leave the kids here, shop downtown Rochester, that
correct.
Kind of thing?
Correct.
Have a little break from her from the parenting duties.
Right. Yep. We're going to be opening that up here in the next couple months, so that it's set up, you know, a little bit better, a little more convenient for the parents. The challenge with that approach is reminding the parents to call ahead.
So you get their cell phone numbers, I assume, or
sure,
way of contacting them.
Certainly, contacting us. I mean, there's staffing considerations that we have. I would say that most of our parents all call ahead appropriately, but it can be discouraging when we don't have the staff in place to keep our ratios, our child care ratios in line, you know, if they're dropping in last minute. So even calling ahead, if in an emergency basis, you know, at a last minute standpoint, you know, we can at least let them know that we do have capacity to take their kids at that point or not.
Okay, and the website is?
RochesterPlay.com.
Okay, great. Thanks a lot, Jeff.
Thank you.